this is the map we do, and now let's see what do they choose. And it's gonna be Mirage.
They have already taken a lead with two games, which is Real Cricket and Tekken 7.
Yeah, they have a comfortable lead of 12 points, the Yakshas. And Akramaks are lagging behind. They need to pull up their socks this game if they have to stay alive in this league against the Yakshas. And Yakshas putting up a great performance, taking away the cricket and the Tekken game today. And Akramaks trying to make a comeback and trying to win this. The CSGO is the best bet because they have the strongest team. As far as my knowledge is concerned, they have the strongest team in the game. And as I say, they have won the knife round also. And let's see whether they decide to stay or swap. Will they be playing as terrorists or counter-terrorists? Just let's wait and watch.
Because I think so they've just won. Okay, so they have stayed.
But they have decided otherwise, and they will be playing as counter-terrorists first. And let the game begin.
Let's see today what does his team, SMX, well, didn't perform that well yesterday. But today there might be some changes or some stats. The briefing would have been better.
There's a minor change on the Yakshas side. Revolt has been rested for this game and Starboy has been brought in again in the roster. So let's see whether Starboy can live up to the expectation and whether he can make a good comeback, or will the Yakshas be fighting for finding a right fifth guy or a right team setup, you can call it. Mm-hmm. They don't have a nice combination going in the Counter-Strike global offensive scene. All of their other games are marked pretty well. Just they're lagging behind in the Counter-Strike and they're not getting the right set of combinations. Akramaks, on the other hand, have a beautiful lineup consisting of Kappa, Batman, SMX, Man and Mithila playing competitive Counter-Strike on the past 4 to 5 years, and a well-known name in the industry, esports industry. And as we say, first round and over.
Moving to balance, the C4 is just holding there, and one guy would be actually checking the backstab for them, and one is at slope. So there are two players who's holding for them for back, looking for backstabs. And the flash goes in. The smokes are already out by the team. There would be an entry from the T's on the bomb side. Exchange of the tag. Batman get exchanged by Starboy. And instantly Manan has been also gone by Mantri. So it's a 3v3 situation. Sarush is on a CZ.
The three experienced guys, Kappa, SMX and Mithila, still alive on the Akramaks side. They're very much in it. And Mithila spotted one guy who is at the mid. SMX gets a good headshot on Impale out over there. 2v3 scene, let's see whether Skadoosh and Mantri can hold. Mantri just holding his fortress at A slope and he has been spotted, but Mithila takes on Mantri. Skadoosh the only guy remaining, and the bomb has been defused on. Akramaks take the first round. A good start for the Akramaks out over here, taking the first round. And that was good patience play from the Akramaks side. They did.
So both teams have like good economy because they got the C4 plant, and they also had a the CDs had a smoke, so it actually helped them defuse the bomb properly. And there was only two players, and he was actually covered by both sides as well by his teammates, so it was good for him.
And this is what experience brings you. SMX, Mithil and
rush.
Kappa.
A 5-man rush had made. They are moving towards connectors very aggressively. Kappa is just waiting there, but Impale moving towards Kappa. He gets a backstab. And Kappa pulling down two guys with one. It's a nice headshot. Manan pulls out one more frag. Starboy goes down. And Skadoosh has been shut down on the connectors. Mithil takes an easy frag on Skadoosh.
So a good rush from the Yakshas side, but they couldn't get the entry frag. So Kappa took them down easily. No one was marking the connector, and that was a good call from the Yakshak side. But they didn't manage to pull even a single kill out over there. So no luck for the Yakshak side, and they have they have planted the C4 in the first round. So this is the reason why they have gone for their weapon in the third round. And let's see Starboy marking mid.
He's actually waiting for Kappa just for a peek, but Kappa is not going to move out so easily. Was that Molly like push Starboy out of the position? But no, he is still holding there. But he do have like good utilities to work with. They have like two smokes to enter a side. That's enough for them just to move on a side.
And it's unusual. No one is marking the nest. Kappa is playing at the connector and the nest is quite open. And if they stay, and if they manage to get a stack at the nest side, Kappa just marking underpass right now. He's trying to gauge, is there any movement over there?
Impel
was caught napping out over there. He was just marking nest, but there was no one marking nest. And Batman takes on Karush. So two guys already down on the Yakshas side.
A nice tactic by Batman over there for Kappa. Well, Kappa is very low on HP. It's a 3-on-5 situation. The C4 is actually moving towards the apartment. It's a very slow move by Mantri, and Mantri has also performed well in the previous games. He has been like playing consistent. His game is it's not like very, very up to the mark, but it's not even low. He is performing decent.
And Kappa just moving on to the B side. He's getting some info that the A, that there's not much of sound happening on the SMH A side.
But SMH is on a nice posey. He is just holding, and that he won't expect him to be here because they don't have like much time to deal with. And he picks down SMH. He just picks down Reaper, but Mantri actually the flag. They stop, but also it's a 2v3 situation. The C4 will go down now, and they have to come for a retake. A smoke pops in the road to block their entry. The Manan coming for a backstab from B shot. Well, he spots Mantri over there, but he couldn't do much. The shots won't connect for them. And the frag has exchanged having a 1-on-1 situation. One on the other, both are low on HP. And Manan takes the final frag on Starboy. He goes for the defuse.
And Mantri and Starboy almost pulled that off for Yakshas, but the Manan, the giant, coming in and showing them who's the boss right over here. And Manan gets a good kill. Manan is performing really well for the Akramaks from the past 2 to 3 games. He's an asset to any team, you can call it. Such a calm mind on such a huge shoulders, and that is how it's done. And he's showing the team how it should be done, because he never gets panicked. He never gets frustrated. He just lets the game do his talking.
Well, that you get that over the years, because like so many years of playing this game, and like after that you get that experience. To have this experience, like it's not easy to just. People do think like it's just a game, but for few players like who are playing this professionally, it's not just a game to them. It's the years of experience they have put in the game, the practice, the dedication, everything that matters for this thing. What are your thoughts?
Experience does matter. And it's always good to have experienced players in your side, so they know how to react in various situations.
Akramaks have already built like a whole lineup of experience.
Yeah, they have a very experienced lineup. They have invested heavily in their Counter-Strike team. Just look at the names. You could send down Shivas to any team.
Like Mithil has been playing for 10 years, Kappa for 10, Manan for 6 approx, SMX also for 5 years, and Batman, I'm not sure with how many years he is, but he's also good. It looked like a technical pause for the players. They are like still fixing the technical issue.
Pause still on. We are waiting to get it done as soon as possible. But these things
just
keep on happening.
Going for an eco. If you see, they are actually going for an eco. They do have upgraded pistols with 3 deagles coming in. So I don't think so. Like they would like go for a rush strategy if they have like 3 deagles. They would actually mark posies differently or like together. Let's see. The game is unpaused. Technical issue has been solved, and we will be now going into the game again. And on the P side, they are on eco, so we will see 3 upgraded pistols. And on the CT side, they are fully loaded with rifles and utilities that they can work with. Only SMX is not with a kit, others are.
Yeah, we have been talking this day and day out. People need to get their kits, because it's quite easier to attempt the defuse. Because otherwise it takes 10 seconds if you don't have a kit, and with the kit it takes you only 5 seconds, and 5 seconds matter because the round time is only 1.75 minutes. Mm-hmm. So 5 seconds is quite a huge time, and it's always better to be safe than sorry.
It looks like the C4 is still holding on to you because he's AFK. Okay, he's not AFK, he's just marking that posey well. I thought he was just AFK going in the tournament.
How can he be AFK in a live game, Jaren?
Well, that happens.
Sometimes playing like lots of competitive online, you have the tendency to call people AFK when they're marking a posy, and Skaru is trying to enter through A slope, but he hasn't been spotted yet, but he has been spotted by the guy who's marking CD base now. And let's see whether he can get a kill with his deagles. Deagle is his favorite weapon.
Kappa has made an entry from the stairs, but the players would be falling back. I think Skaru should fall back because it's not like a good strategy to like wait there more. I know he is actually going for a fake, but if he dies, there would be a loss for him. Like, look at Impaler, he's already low on HP. And yes, even Skadoosh is like taking a little bit damage, but he had given a nice headshot. Kappa just got shocked over there. And Manan picking up Skadoosh one by one frag. And SMX gets on two guys with a nice headshot. Mantri coming in with a headshot for SMX, and he goes down. But instant trade has been made by Mithil. It's a 3v1 situation. Impaler is very low on HP. He is just 9, just a tap of a bullet. He goes down by Mithil. That's an amazing round. 4-0, the scoreline stands over here.
And Akramaks having a comfortable lead of 4 games to love, and the match is paused again. Maybe some tech issue which has relapsed, and let's see what happens.
Well, that was a nice execution by the T's, but they didn't do it well. But now looking at them, they do have resources to work with. They have like 2 flashes on Impaler, like totally of they have 6 flashes, 3 smokes and 3 mollies to work with, and they do have armor as well. Mantri does op really well. I have played with him. Yeah, I have played with him, and he was opening for me like when we used to play online. So
online and a LAN game is totally 2 different scenarios. Online, you play at the comfort of your home, you don't have much coordination, and you can use each and every weapon that you wish. But when you're LANing with your teammates, it's a completely different scenario. You need to give respect to the team, the teammates, and you need to act as per their strategy. The match still being paused.
It looks like if a tech pause, the players are looking confused. And Mithil, what's up? He's just staring at me from the stage. Okay, so it looks like there is a system being changed, I think so. So there will be a huge technical pause. So we'll be right back. This is me, Jireen, and T2 with me. We will be right back after this break.
The fuck, yeah.
लाउड हो थोड़ा तेरा आवाज नहीं आ रहा है
आवाज नहीं आ रहा है अरे मेरी आवाज बैठी पड़ी है
टेक्निकल पॉज रहेगा उतना डिस्क्रिप्शन नहीं दे सकते कुछ हुआ ही नहीं बिकॉज इट्स जस्ट
So finally, we are back to the beginning. After a huge technical pause, this is Akramaks versus Yakshas. This bottom is the scoreline. Currently, the off was cut to 13. Yes, he is ready, but Kappa is pushing way more aggressive than he used to.
I guess they have not lost him. They thought he has gone under one. But no. A nade would be doing considerable damage, and yes, it has. Kadush is low on 8 HP, so the offer is low for the Yakshak side. And that was a nice rush by Kappa doing, succeeding in doing what he thought. But couldn't get down Skadoosh, but he has damaged him considerably. He has taken 92 HP out of Skadoosh, and Skadoosh is just lurking around and would not be able to take aggressive shots right now.
Kappa is just now playing peekaboo with the team. He's just like your sporting man.
And just the way the Akramaks are playing, they are just playing freely without any...
Yeah, Kappa does spot three players at mid, and now they would be giving a call, but they haven't spotted the C4 because the C4 is actually just moving at the bomb site B. And SMX has a nice shot. If Mantri moves in slowly, he is gonna surely get a huge damage or gonna die. And there goes Mantri. SMX with a nice shot coming in.
That's quite a difficult shot to hit, but SMX, the kind of player he is,
yeah,
he does it quite easily because there's very small room for error out over there. And they have jumped.
Players are flash dabbing. SMX goes down. Impaler with a nice headshot. It's a 4v4 situation. Skadoosh goes down. It's a 4v3 now. And the C4 is onside. The C4 will go down soon. And the C4 has been banded. Kappa picks down recoil. And the exit of flash has been made. Impaler takes down Kappa. Starboy alone guy left. In this situation, 1v3. And he goes down as well. The C4 is going to go defuse. Akramaks taking a huge lead. 5-0.
So the pause. There's no considerable change of game style for the Akramaks. They are still playing aggressive, and the pause doesn't make any difference to their confidence. They came back with another round. The scoreline stands 5-0. Yakshak still not able to open their account, still finding themselves wanted, and they are not pulling off the strategies really well right over here. And Akramaks are all over them right now. And the recoil master misses a shot on Kappa. It could be a costly miss out over there, because taking out a player like Kappa at the start of the round can boost your confidence immensely. And Skadoosh takes down Badman, but still the four giants remaining for the Akramaks. And it's come down to 3, Kappa, SMX and Manan, only guys surviving. And let's see whether Yakshas can open their account this round. And Kappa takes down Mantri, and Manan has pushed up A house.
That was a mistake by him. A one tap on him and switches the weapon and goes down. A huge mistake, but.
And Kappa takes down Manan. That's a team kill.
Oh my god, that's a mistake. That's a huge mistake. Oh my god. And Kappa has no info on about Impaler moving towards the stairs, and he takes down. And SMX, the lone guy left for his team. He is actually moving from the CT spawn, would be going for a backstab.
And he's moving in too fast, but his vision has been blocked. There was Molly in the nest, and there's smoke out over here, so he has nothing to play with. So he just has to go in through the smoke.
It's not even his favorable plant. Like, he has to go for a save because, or he might not end up well.
But they have quite a good of economy left, so SMX would be going in for this round. He has spotted Starboy, and let's see whether he can pull him down. But no, Starboy takes him down, and Yakshas finally opened their account. 5-1, the scoreline stands, and let's see whether Yakshas can get another round and make a comeback.
How can SMX get so low on the economy? But yeah, a drop comes in, right? He makes a save here. Someone actually dropped him, like something like a farmer's.
Because he has bought his pistol, he has bought all his utilities, and he brought his favorite gun, M4A4, so that is why he took a hit on his economy and he couldn't get any kill. So there's no point of extra dollars. You get $300 for each kill you make. And Mantri going into underpass, and SMX has tagged someone has given
a tag. If you see that, like in the previous round also, they did like a pop flash for Mantri, and like then Mantri moves, and it's like the basic strategy that they are still using like each and every round.
I'm liking this gameplay of Yakshas because they're trying to control mid, which is the right thing to do in a map like Mirage. If you can control mid, you dictate the terms out over here. And SMX has made his way to his nest, and Mantri has heard something. He has heard there's someone in the nest, and they have mollied him, but SMX is safe out over there. Oh, and Mantri making his way to the connector.
By the both the teams, like, okay, Kappa is very aggressive with his calls now. Everyone on the stage can hear him, he is so loud. While meanwhile, Luka was a picks, SMS, Impaler picks down Mithil. It's a 3v4 situation. The C4 is there is a guy holding, that's Kappa on the side. He picks down Impaler, making it a 3v3 situation. Equal lies for this team.
And Recall Master with his AWP marking the market area, and Badman also made his way up to the B side, and the A side is open, but they are playing only B out right over there. Charboy takes down Badman, and Recall Master takes on Kappa, and Recall Master takes on Manan. So the second round, a trot for the Yakshas. A good play by Recall Master, and they also managed to plant in the C4, so extra dollars for that. And Yakshas taking a 2-round from the Akramaks. Akramaks won't be liking it, losing 2 rounds with such a good lineup. But nevertheless, they have to go eco this round. And
the Akramaks economy has been destroyed very badly, and this is not going well for them. They have no like utilities to work with. There's no flash, no smokes, no kit, nothing. So they would just go for like the exit frags, maybe.
And Recall Master missing that shot on the guy who was lurking around at the A side, but couldn't get the kill. Kappa making his way down the B shot and making his way slowly up to the high mid, and Skadoosh takes on Badman, but Manan gets a good headshot on Skadoosh, and so it's quite even for both the teams. 4 guys on either side, and Kappa slowly making his way to the T base. Would it be dangerous? He has spotted Mantri, and he takes on Mantri, so 3v3. A nice exchange happening, and Manan takes down Impale, and 3v2 situation. It's all for Akramaks to lose this round. And will Manan get the kill on Recall Master? He does, and Kappa helps him with that. Starby, the only guy surviving the T side, he's making his way to the spam box, and he would be hunted down shortly, I guess. But let's see. And Manan gets
the shot.
Manan just destroying Yakshas this round. A good eco round from the Akramaks.
They had nothing, like, they had like zero things on them. They had like only pistols, not even armor.
And they made this round up from scratch. They had nothing. They just had the pistols. And kafi acha round nikala unhone. And Yakshas kafi slow khel gaye wo round mein. They gave Akramaks too much time to rush. Walk karke Kappa ne pura mid B se B shot aaya, B shot se T base aaya. Kafi time mila Kappa ko, and Kappa took down
SMX
gets down. It's like a pre-frag for SMX there. And
he's still going for the cap, and Mantri just there was a slight movement coming in.
You can call this indecisiveness from Yakshas. There's a mix by coming in. Mantri with his AK and Skadoosh with his Deagle. So not a good round this for the Yakshas. And Skadoosh making his way.
Like AK from someone's body, I think so. But meanwhile, Manan takes a lone guy left. He also takes a headshot and goes down by SMX. Things not looking good for Yaksha. 72 the scoreline stands.
72?
72 the scoreline stands. Not 72.
Yeah, 72 is a hell lot of rounds, and
we don't want to go there.
We don't want to go there. It would be quite a toll on a, what do you call it, vocal cord. And Yakshas going in with their pistols again, because they have
only one flash in Mantri, and even that has been popped out somewhere on the map. Well, the thieves have made an entry, and Badman being the Badman over here, he gets 3 frags and goes down. And the Yakshas are getting destroyed, they're getting eliminated by the CTs.
Badman doing justice to his name, playing very bad and taking down 3 guys in just
bad, like, isn't good.
Yeah, that isn't good. 3 kills in 3 seconds, not bad either. And finally, Yakshas is managing to buy their weapons.
Yeah, they do have like utilities that they have, like, purchased. Only like 1, 2, 4, 5 flashes. That is enough to gain the cause being called by Kappa. Kappa is giving like so aggressive calls, but he is so loud. He is louder than us.
And Kappa missed the shot. It was an easy shot. He had two guys and he had only one bullet to him because aapke ek hi bullet mein samne wala aksar they die. And Skadoosh is crouching and making his way up to the connector, which is not a wise thing to do because he has a mollet B shot as well.
Actually, no one is marking there, so he is still safe to just make any movement he wants to. There's no guy who is actually spotting Skadoosh, and even Batman is looking down. There is no angle for Recoil Master as well.
Like so Recoil Master would be backstabbing this round because they're coming to the connector and they all would be watching connector and as they enter, and Recoil Master would be able to get some frags. Let's see whether he succeeds.
Manan is ready for the shot and Skadoosh goes down with taking a headshot.
They do have a one-man lead on Akramaks, and SMX picks down Impaler with a nice headshot.
So the Yakshas falling apart out over here, taken down easily by the Akramaks. Oh, but as we say, Starboy gets a kill on Batman and they have entered A side, which would be which is not a good thing for the Akramaks. They have control of the A side. Recoil Master with 16 HP takes on Mithil. But Manan, there's a nice trade-off out over there. Manan takes on Recoil Master. Kappa takes on Mantri and the formalities remain. Starboy taken down by SMX. The Akramaks are on fire right now, just taking down Yakshas like 9 pins, and Yakshas don't know what is happening around them.
They should actually go for a tactical pause because they need to change.
I guess there should be no pauses out over there because we had too much time in the tactical pause and they had enough time to rethink the strategies, but nothing has worked from them till now.
According to the current scenario, they have to actually go and rethink, like they have to rebuild their strategy because this is not working for them. Even on like
yeah, this is not working for them. They are being destroyed.
3 deagles pop in again without any armor.
3 deagles, 2 pistols. That has been the story. One round they buy the AKs, they drop it. Next round they buy the deagles, they drop it, and repeat.
Goes on.
Period.
Goes in a loop.
Goes in a loop. So the same strategy being used by the Yakshas. No pop flash, no smoke, nothing. Just entering like a freebie. This is not a garden. This is Mirage and you're facing Akramaks. So you need to pull up your socks, use your utilities. They should be going in for the A smokes. The default thing to do when nothing is going well for you.
They should actually play a little bit aggressive compared to what they are playing now.
They're going for the split push and the backstab, which is not working for them. So they should play as a team and rush together. There's no fun dying alone. Let's die together. If that clicks, it would be good.
Kappa does see Skadoosh and Skadoosh will fall back. Well, Kappa missing a shot on Skadoosh,
which rarely happens, but SMX spotting them, giving no chance. And apne pair pe kuladi mari liya tha, lekin bach gaye. He just self-naded, but no damage taken, so that all is well for SMX there.
All is well. Well, on the T side, like they do have like proper smokes to work with to enter the side, but let's see when will they execute. And looking at the current scenario, there is only one guy who is going to back up, that is Recoil Master, who is actually going to go for a backstab. But with the op, that's a huge decision to make, like to backstab with an op.
Not a good decision by Skadoosh out over there. He shouldn't have gone for the entry back. He's so low on HP and Manan takes down 2. Impair and Shaw by Mantri takes down Manan. A 4v2 situation. Mantri and Recoil Master remaining for the Yakshak side. And there are 3 guys on the Akramak side. Recoil Master takes on Batman. Mantri with 100 HP looking around the Nesh connector side. And he has been spotted by Kappa. But Kappa takes him down. Mantri having the advantage, he had a proper shot on Kappa. So in normal world, you get the kill. But in Kappa's world, Kappa gets the kill. So Mantri just making, not able to get the kill on Kappa.
But that reflex was very slow.
You have to give it to Kappa there.
No, but
you cannot say that Mantri's reflex was slow. You can say that Kappa's reflex was fast.
No, Kappa moved in. There was a time like I saw like those frames properly. Like Mantri had a chance before him.
And this is getting too easy for the Akramaks out over here. They are just fragging. They are like they are doing some kind of a practice out over here. And Impale and Skadoosh going down very quickly in the start of the round. And Batman finally is taken down by Starboy, but after inflicting much damage on Mantri. Mantri with 29 HP, just a nade move. A nade and he's done.
And he is gone. He will be lane middle. Oh my god, SMX is up there. It's a Mantri. The C4 has gone down. But Recoil Master, will he be able to pull this round? It's a 1v1 situation. Recoil Master on 2 kills and Kappa has an op. Aggressive with him, and yes, Kappa finally does this. He picks down Recoil Master.
Kappa showing who's the captain out over here and taking down Recoil Master. Recoil Master, a very good upcoming player, but he couldn't survive to see another round. And the scoreline stands 12 games to 2. Akramaks running away with the show currently. It would be over sooner than expected.
Well, this is the last round of the first half. 12 to 2 the scoreline stands. This can be anyone's round because both the teams looking good with the utilities and the weapons. And Kappa with the op. He's actually currently going towards mid. He might pick his left. Okay, Kappa is actually misses the shot. The players will flag.
And SMX gets the skill on Skadoosh. Skadoosh is dying very cheaply. He's been taken down every round at the start and not helping his team's cause. And Mantri and Impale just carrying the flag of the Yakshas. Only the two guys remain compared to Akramaks, which are four guys still alive. And Impale marking connector. And SMX is just looking around B shot. Just trying to pass on info.
He is just like waiting to just give the info. He is now reading the game for the T side.
And I guess Mantri is giving
one-sided game for Akramaks. Akramaks leading with a huge score, and SMX, that wrong push coming in from him, and gets punished instantly. Mantri takes him down, and Batman from behind picks Mantri and Mithil, as will pick down Impaler.
And the scoreline is 13 games to 2. Too easy for the Akramaks out over here. And Yakshas should be doing something very magnificent to make a comeback. They need to. If Yakshas make a comeback, this would be once in a decade game, you can say it, but.
Well, also, it was a nice decision by Akramaks. They won the knife round and they said that they would stay and play as CT, and it proved right. They played really well. Their stats worked for them. Not for Yakshas, of course.
Not a single player in double digits for the Yakshas and compared to the Akramaks.
Yeah, I just noticed that.
And the kills have been properly being distributed at the Akramaks side. There's everyone performing and up to the mark. Compared to the Yakshas.
Look at Mithil. Mithil has like zero assists. He doesn't need anyone. He'll go for the solo kill.
Never a good sign when your death is higher than your kills. It's never a good sign for you and your team and for your game. And let's see whether they can stop the Akraman from the Akramaks, right? So Akramaks moving in very swiftly to the B side. And they have taken a pause, and Mithil trying to get the entry, and they would be entering B with the kind of setup they are going for.
Yes.
They would be waiting for all the smoke and flash from the Yakshas side to be utilized before they make an entry, so that they are not caught off guard. And Starboy mocking B house by taking an open shot, which is not a wise thing to do in front of Akramaks because they are very good with their aim.
But there are two guys who are holding there, and one guy is already ready for the rotation. He is still holding market, and yes, they do hear like flashes, and the players get flashes. They do hear players' movement coming in on the bomb side, and Akramaks being very Akraman on them. And Badman picks on Swaboy, and one more flag as well. The Akramaks are very aggressive on them right now, and Mars is just too good. He is actually on a dual fight with Impaler, but he will go down soon because he is very low on HP.
He's playing like there's no tomorrow.
Mithil has the knight back up, like get two headshots nicely.
And no casualty on the Akramak side, taking the round pretty easily.
It was a flawless
round. No damage is taken, no casualty. So they have the economy, they have their money stashed up, and they can use it in the next round. And it's all but over for Yakshas, you can tell it from now, because they have lost the first round, so no economy to play with and not much to do. They just need to spray and pray right now. So the bullets would hit.
Well, we can see a few upgraded pistols on the city side, and Mantri with the Bison. That's a unique buy for this tournament. Like, I haven't seen anyone like buying an SMG that to Bison.
Bison, which has the least damage, but it has too many 64 bullets.
Oh, well, Manan, this is a proper angle.
And they have smoked.
Headshot to Batman. He gets down one, but goes down instantly. Manan making a trade flag over there, and a 2v4 situation. The tees.
And Kappa just staying jumping. Japan got over there, just jumping his way to the nest from the B shot, and middle taking down Mantri. On to the formalities remain. Starboy just lost his HP like an action movie, like 180, 60, 20, 20 gone. And last one for the Akramaks. All but sure, they would be taking away this match pretty easily because no economy left on the Yakshas side. They only have the pistols and Akramaks.
This is totally a YOLO round for Yakshas. Like, they have, this is a do or die situation for them.
It's pretty easy for Akramaks with the kind of players they have in their team. If someone defeats them, it would be no short of a miracle, you can say, because they have the strongest team, going by the ranks and going by the names. They are the strongest team on paper, and that's what they're showing right now. We are not strong on paper, we are strong as a team also. And just waiting to get this round over. They are not rushing in. This is what experience brings you. Not getting carried away with the momentum they are carrying, but they are giving respect to their opponents. And Mithil takes down Recoil Master, Mithil takes down Skadoosh. It's like I'm reading a news bulletin over and over again, the same news bulletin. The same casualty. Skadoosh doing it same on both the sides.
3v3 situation had been made by the city side. That's impressive. Like, they have already moved to the side. The bomb goes down. It's a 3v3 situation. Players are on pistols and the T's are on rifles. This can be anyone's round right now because they have to. Like, they work. They are actually playing good with their pistols. And the C4 is really an open front, and they now know. And Mantri does work the guy, but he is on HP, but takes him down with a headshot. 2v2 situation, players are low on HP, but Manan, nice headshot. Impale just smoking there. Nice backup, but SMX takes down the final frag. 16-2 the scoreline. This is a totally one-sided match.